A spacesuit is a pressurized garment that astronauts will wear that is meant to recreate the conditions on Earth.
When you go out to the vacuum of space, that's the only thing that's keeping you alive.
Spacewalks can be as long as 8 hours, and an astronaut cannot simply go back inside to use the bathroom. But the problem is solved by the maximum absorbency garment.
Very fancy word for an adult diaper.
Everybody wore diapers at some point, so I guess if you're an astronaut, you're just going back to your roots.
When you get into the spacesuit, the first thing you do is you put on your diaper, and then you put on your cooling garment.
Without the cooling undergarment, the astronaut certainly could overheat because inside the spacesuit, there's nowhere for the body heat to escape.
Spacesuits have been around a really long time, and they've gone through several generations where they get better and better.
The first astronaut suits on the moon were actually more flexible latex suits. Today, humans can move around a lot more than they could in previous spacesuits.
With only 2 EMUs on the International Space Station, the spacesuits have to be shared.
So they have different sizes, medium, large, extra large. They can be reconfigured.
And it's designed to be able to accommodate 95% of the astronauts.
The main suit is comprised of the HUT, which stands for Hard Upper Torso, and the Lower Torso.
In total, there's about 11 layers to the spacesuit shell, a bladder layer to regulate pressure, 5 layers of mylar to regulate temperature, a waterproof layer, a fireproof layer, a bulletproof layer in case any space gangsters float by. That's a joke.
One of the layers in the spacesuit makes you space dust proof.
Space dust is created from asteroids. It comes at you about the speed of a speeding bullet. If it's going super fast, no matter how small it is, it's going to hurt you. And those 11 layers really protect you.
The communications carrier assembly is what you put on your head. It has earphones and a microphone for you to communicate with the station and the ground.
The cloth cap fastens under the chin and keeps the headset in place on the astronaut's head.
We call the CCA, the communications carrier assembly, the Snoopy cap.
When Snoopy used to fight with the Red Baron, he used to have that World War I flight cap, and that's why we call it the Snoopy cap.
The helmet is essentially a clear plastic bubble that allows the astronaut to breathe.
There's a gold visor that comes down in case you're in the direct sunlight. If it's very, very bright and you're having to work, you have another metal visor that comes down like the visor on your car.
This visor assembly has a camera system. We also have a couple of lamps to work in the dark. And you have a straw right here at your mouth. You can just drink all the water you want.